Come in. Where would you like it, sir?
On the table there.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. Thank you. No, thank you.
Irregularity in the electrical impulse.
Down hand again.
How much further behind is that foot, Doctor?
I don't know until I've done a full analysis.
Try an educated guess.
All right. I don't know. A couple of days, maybe.
Easy. Back the dermal pad.
Need I remind you, our budget's up for review in 7 weeks.
And need I remind you, Dr. Heller, that if that hand in there can't play piano without setting itself on fire, we'll all be working at the corner auto shop rebuilding transmissions.
Dr. Simmons, Eve 8 is being made ready for her test run in lab number 4.
Oh, I love this jacket. It's a wonderful jacket. I think I need a purse. Thank you. Feels very good. How do I look?
Thank you.
Freeze! On the floor! Freeze, asshole! On the floor! Get down! Now you wanna die? Down! Get down! Freeze the kid! I said get down!
Okay, let's do it.
La verdad, hermano, ¿no?
Sí, la verdad.
Bueno, trabajando.
Des Moines, Saperstein, Carter. You're all dead.
Jesus.
And each would have an epitaph. He died for his country because he didn't fucking listen. You know, I wonder how many times I'm gonna have to tell you guys, you never relax. You never let down your guard. Not for one second. Fix that up. Things are not always what they seem. So now, just to show you men who's really God around here, I'm going to miraculously bring you all back to life. Move! is there! Murder, sir! Get the hell out of here! Get onto that chopper! What you do, pack for me? All right, Carter, take charge!
Yes, sir. This is somebody even bigger than God.
Fall out!
Mom, can we go over this?
1 second, Tim.
Tim, what are you doing?
Hey. Let me see.
This is a man, this is a woman, this is a vagina.
What?
Mom, there's nothing to be embarrassed about.
You're right.
Hello? No, I'm sorry. Dr. Simmons cannot be disturbed.
Those are tits.
Who taught you that?
Not Daddy, I swear.
Tim, they're breasts. The other word's not nice, okay?
Okay, breasts. Want to know what those are called?
Those? You tell me.
Balls! Daddy did tell me that. Oh.
Dr. Simmons, do you have a telephone call?
Maria, I told you no calls.
I'm sorry, it's Dr. Heller, and he says he must speak to you.
You have to talk some more, young man.
Okay.
You better have a damn good reason for calling me today. What? Okay, I'll be there. Give me an hour. Here. Bye. I have to go. We'll have to take Timmy to the airport. It's an emergency. Hey, Maria will take you to the airport, okay?
Okay.
But I'll call you before you leave. And Tim, we'll go to the aquarium another time, I promise. I want to kiss. Oh, bye, somebody. Oh, and remember, they're called testicles. Bye, sweetie.
Jim, this is Bill Schneider from the NSC.
I've heard a lot about you, Colonel.
Sir, have a seat. Look, I know you're pissed. And it's understandable given all the hard work you put in. But this hostage crisis is just going to have to wait.
Sir, we don't get those people out soon, they're not coming out. At least not alive.
Colonel, the hostages are no longer our top priority. The plain fact is we have a more pressing problem.
Jim, you're about to be brought in on this country's best kept secret.
The following message has the highest classification. This is Project Rob, 25 years ago. The aim was to design a robot that could pass as human. As you can see, the state of robotics then was very primitive. Today, this is Eve 8, state of the art. To enable her to pass as a convincing human being, she has been programmed with the thoughts and feelings of her inventor, Dr. Eve Simmons. Please be aware, Dr. Simmons was also used as a model for Eve 8's face and body structure and her memory programs. Eve 8 has been designed for surveillance work, but can also be used as a potent battlefield weapon. Eve 8 is currently completing a series of test runs in the Bay Area. Message ends.
This thing for real?
What do you mean?
Well, I knew we were doing some robot research, but this thing is
incredible.
Incredible is not a strong enough word, sir.
I was on a test run in the Bay Area this morning. These were taken by the bank's security cameras. As you can see, Eve 8 got herself shot. Point is, when she was shot, somehow, and we have no idea, it screwed up her internal workings. Now she's on the loose.
And armed.
Oh, and armed, you bet.
Okay, so let me ask some maybe stupid questions here. Do you know where she is now?
No, our trace on her was knocked out at the time of the shooting.
So there's no way to communicate with her?
That's affirmative.
When we eventually do find her, how do we switch her off?
It's not as simple as that, Colonel. She's more human than machine.
You see, Jim, she's just like a regular soldier. You give her instructions and she carries them out.
How dangerous is she?
She could be highly dangerous if she's locked in battlefield mode.
What's that?
Battlefield mode is Eve 8's highest state of readiness. It means she's a split second away from using force to protect herself from what she perceives as terminal harm.
So I guess that means she's no longer in the mood to accept orders from a superior officer.
That's correct.
Well, this is quite some toy you have yourselves here, gentlemen. I suppose you want me to put it back in its box.
It's not a toy, Colonel.
Dr. Simmons, I'm glad you could come on such short notice.
I was offered little choice, General.
Bill Schneider, you know. This is Jim McQuaid, Eve Simmons.
Something wrong?
No. No, you just look kind of familiar.
Don't worry, she's quite human.
Well, that's not what my staff say, General.
Jim has been briefed on the situation. I hope you two are going to be able to work together on this.
Doctor, I'm told that Eve 8 has been programmed with a lot of your own life experiences. Does that mean you think exactly alike?
Yes, she was programmed with much of my life experience, but we're not exactly alike, no. Just exactly what are your qualifications, Mr. McQuaid? What's your specialty?
Well, to tell the truth, Doctor, my specialty is a spinach lasagna and a very light tomato and basil sauce.
Actually, Doctor, Mr. McQuaid is highly trained and thoroughly knowledgeable in all aspects of counterinsurgency and anti-terrorism. He's our very best field man. He will neutralize Eve 8.
So your specialty is killing?
Which brings me to my next question, Doctor. How do I kill this thing?
One seriously wounded, and a customer, also believed wounded, mysteriously disappeared after overpowering one of the robbers. This just in.
One arm was in the gate, the other was in the making around 2 o'clock this morning. One of the customers said,
her areas of vulnerability naturally are approximate to those of a real human. All the motor signals that control her limbs come down the backbone, which has a strong protective coating.
What's that cylinder?
That's just part of her protection.
Okay, what about the heart? Will the bullet there stop her?
No. Her heart, well, in fact, her whole blood system is cosmetic. They're designed to let her medically pass as human, but they have no real medical function. It's tiny electrical currents that power her. She'll bleed, but she won't die.
So upper and lower body are not good for a kill?
Correct. The skull is very protective. A good place to aim would be right or left eyes. Those are both vulnerable areas. A bullet through either eye should terminate all motor activity.
So I guess the eyes have it then, huh, Doc?
Call sign Seeker. We'll be Homer. We're also getting you a chopper with civilian markings. Now, as far as the rest of the world is concerned, and that includes press and police, we'll simply be searching for a dangerous female terrorist.
This will tell you if we're dealing with the unthinkable. If she goes nuclear, you'll hear a high-pitched tone.
He doesn't know.
He doesn't need to. The less people who know, the better. Don't worry. I'm told he's our very best marksman. He's been fully briefed. He'll aim for the eyes.
Sir? Eve Ace rented herself a car in the Bay Area. A red 1990 Mustang. She's also got herself 250 rounds of ammunition. They say she also specifically requested and was given a detailed map of Northern California.
Very nice.
Very nice.
Hey, Cal. Don't go getting greedy on us.
Don't worry.
What's that old line? One for all and all for one.
Go to it, man.
What are you looking for? Maybe I can help.
Get it while you can. Janis Joplin.
Janis Joplin? Not on this machine, darling. Dear Janis was dead before this box was even built. What do you say, you and me? Step into the 90s.
Hmm? Why don't we just go take a room?
Sweep to the right and head north on US 1.
Roger, copy that. So, Doctor, you want to start telling me a little bit about yourself? See, because I figure the more I know about you, the better my chances are of catching up with your mechanical double.
Didn't you read my file?
I read your file. You're 33 years old. You got a 5-year-old son, lives in New York with his father, your ex-husband. Former UN diplomat turned writer, journalism mostly. Probably have more qualifications and letters behind your name than our friend the general's got ribbons on his chest. But that hardly gets me to first base with what I'm dealing with here.
And what about your file, Mr. McQuaid?
My file is classified. But then you don't need to read my file to know I'm a great guy.
So you're the guy the government calls when they don't want Congress to know?
Sometimes. Don't get me wrong, I'm not some crazy right-wing extremist.
So what do you believe in?
Me, I believe in a strong defense. I also believe we should show a little bit more backbone when dealing with some of the evils of this world, international terrorism being the prime one. Also, automated bank tellers, junk mail, and cars to talk back to.
So you don't like machines? Is that why you seem to have contempt for what I do?
It's not contempt. It's disbelief.
Disbelief?
I find it incredible that someone as clever as yourself spend billions of the taxpayers' dollars, years of hard work, and you come up with something that don't even have a fucking off switch.
A little late to get cold, isn't it? Excuse me. Do you want your pearls? Come here. Hey,
372. We found that Mustang. Why don't you send us some backup?
Now for the big surprise.
Come on. It's not a gun.
Come on. Come on.
Say hello.
Come to me.
Come on, you bitch.
Please don't say that.
Oh, no?
I'm very sensitive.
I'm sorry.
I didn't know you were a sensitive bitch.
Dead, Homer.
Five. It's five cops, Jim.
Oh.
We don't want to confuse these people.
Talking about McCall?
McQuaid.
Yeah, whatever. I ain't had more than one shooting here in the last 3 years, and that was some clown that went and shot himself in the foot. Now I got myself a fucking war zone. Some broad comes in here and blows away a bunch of my people. Suddenly, it's out of my jurisdiction.
Captain, I understand.
Oh, you do, huh? Well, maybe you'd like to explain that to the families of those troopers.
Excuse me. Homer, this is Seeker.
Go ahead, Seeker.
It's not good, sir. It's like a bad night in West Beirut. This thing's gonna take some stopping. Plus, we have our friends from the media crawling around. This one's not going to go away quietly, sir.
Look, we got to bring in more firepower to stop this thing.
Our story stands, General. This has got to be low profile. That's the way Washington wants it.
Okay, Ruby, I need a description.
Okay, she was blonde, curly blonde hair, wearing a tight black dress, red leather jacket with zippers on it.
How tall?
5'6", 5'7", something
five,
like
six,
that.
5'7".
Yeah, she made it real plain what she was after as soon as she waltzed in the door.
What was that?
She was looking to get laid, plain and simple.
Okay, Ruby, let's go over it one more time.
Waltz?
And where's
this fancy drink?
Waltz
over
to the
TV.
I tell you to stay put.
I know this place.
Have you been here before?
Not exactly, but I know it.
I think I know why she came here.
Let's find some place we can talk.
Okay, guys, in here.
Right behind you.
Come here. Talk in here.
I lived near here for a while. My friends and I drove by this place all the time. We never had the guts to come in here. It's the local hooker joint. But I used to imagine what it might be like.
Mm-hmm. What might be like? What are you trying to say? What? What?
I think Eve 8 may have acted out some kind of fantasy. That's what I'm trying to say.
All right, wait a minute. Let me just get this straight. You're saying this device of yours acted out one of your teenage sex fantasies?
Yes. Incredible as it may seem.
Incredible is not a strong enough word, Doctor. So this device of yours is horny as well as psychopathic. Huh? It's quite a combination in a woman. Look, Doctor, what would you do if you were her, seeing that you seem to be her and she seems to be you?
I don't know what she's gonna do next, okay? I can only give you some clues after the event.
Yeah, well, there might be a few more events before she's through here. Get out, get out. Get the fuck out!
It's not gonna help you getting uptight with me, McQuaid. You have to realize
This is my life's work, and it's all going to waste.
Okay. Okay. Where were you born?
Santa Rosa. But I went to high school near here, Ukiah. I moved around a lot.
Where are your parents?
My mother's dead.
Your father?
I don't know.
What do you mean you don't know? Where's your father?
I don't know! My mother died when I was 6 years old, and I went to live with my grandparents in Europe. Didn't come back until I was 16. I haven't spoken to my father in years. He used to live in Gurneyville. I have no idea where he is now.
What's his name?
Bill. Bill Simmons.
So have you got any other teenage fantasies I should know about?
What?
Oh, shit. I said, have you got any other teenage sexual fantasies I should know about?
God. Am I supposed to put myself through analysis with some guy who's probably never read anything more complex than an Army field manual?
Oh, get over it, lady. Listen, there's 5 dead cops out there thanks to your surveillance device. And along with them comes 5 grieving widows and their fatherless children. And I don't think all that pain and loss can compare to any embarrassment that you might feel, because you've got to talk to me. And you've got to talk to me. Look, we got to work together on this, okay? Now, I want the names of all the places you lived, all the schools you went to, friends, enemies, acquaintances, good memories and bad. I'm going to want the names of your favorite television programs, your favorite food, and if necessary, how you like it done to you. We think Eve 8 may visit some of her inventor's old haunts. I have a list of these places, Homer. I think we should get people on stakeout at some of these locations.
Copy that, Seeker.
Also, I want you to check the whereabouts of one Bill, as in William Simmons. He used to live at 2331 South Harper, Gurneyville. We also know he served as an army engineer in Germany back in the 60s.
Sir, we need to put down and refuel.
Roger, copy that.
There you go, lady. Think about that one.
just shut up and listen to me a second? You and I made a deal, all right? Don't fuck with me like this. It's business. Business is business, Charlie. Friendship has nothing to do with it, all right? No, listen, just shut up a minute, will you? Listen to me. Are you either with the program or you're not with the program? Now, which is it? All right, when I get in, I want everybody smiling, spit and polish, all right?
What's that?
Oh, my God.
What the fuck is that?
She's activated.
Activated? What do you mean she's activated?
I need the radio.
What do you mean she's activated?
I need that radio. Homer, this is Seeker. Come in, please. Homer, this is Seeker. Do you hear me?
Seeker, this is Homer. Target appears to be activated. Repeat. Target appears to be activated.
What the hell's going on? How the hell's this happened?
We don't know. It appears Target has sustained a severe impact.
She's put herself on a 24-hour clock.
She's a battlefield nuclear weapon, Quaid. She's designed to be deployed in hostile countries. She's our answer to their space shield. And if we don't find her in the next 24 hours, she'll explode with enough force to take out 20 to 30 city blocks. Your superiors thought there was no need for you to know. I was following my orders like you're following yours. She can only be activated by a complex series of prearranged signals. She's designed to be fail-safe.
You people are too much. You know that? I mean, you really do think you're God. Except, Doctor, when God created his Eve, he did it to shake us up a little bit. Now you've gone one better and designed her to blow us all the fuck away. May I? Homer, this is Seeker.
Come in, Seeker.
Homer! Just got some real interesting news from the good doctor here. You want to bring me up to speed on this?
Okay, lady?
I need your Jeep.
Well, you can't have my Jeep.
Sir Nepa,
County Sheriff have just given us a location for a traffic accident. The bridge coordinates are Echo Golf, Niner Niner, 45432, and transmission.
Seeker, we have a report of a Jeep being stolen a mile north of crash site. The owner was severely beaten. Jeep is color red. California license 2PXN822.
Yes, I'd like to speak to the owner, Mr. Victor Montoya.
Have an address for Bill Simmons. It's 29 Tompkins Lane, St. Helena.
State police have been notified. Backup's on its way.
How'd you find me?
Victor Montoya.
Victor Montoya. You know old Victor?
Yes. He said to say hi.
I didn't know you knew Victor. That's quite a memory you've got. Well then, I guess you better... come in.
Oh, there you are. Bill Kleino. Oh, Captain, how are you, miss? We set up a briefing for you. Now, this way.
Well, that's 29 Tompkins Lane. The red Jeep report is stolen from Russian Gulf just parked in the driveway. The householder's name is Simpson.
You mean Simmons, right?
The neighbors thought it was Simpson. They could be wrong. Apparently, the guy's some kind of recluse.
Well, that sounds right.
Where's your man?
At the end of the street, but I can get him to...
No, just tell him to stay out of sight. This is my show, Captain.
Who the hell are these guys?
Your new deputies.
Listen, if this thing gets away from us, we may need to create some plausible deniability. Perhaps you guys at Langley could help us out on this.
What do you got in mind?
A little diversionary blame. Perhaps the Iraqis or Libyans. Whoever's top of your shit list.
You recognize this place?
Never seen it before.
Lieutenant.
Excuse me, ma'am. Sir.
She gets past me. Hold your fire. She fires at you. Take cover. Do not, I repeat, do not fire back. Understood?
But, sir.
Understood?
Yes, sir.
Your job, Lieutenant, is to keep track of her, not take her out. Got it?
Yes, sir.
All right. Things don't go my way in there. You start talking to General Curtis at the Presidio. The call sign is Homer. You got it?
Yes, sir.
All right, that's gonna get you through. Open channel. Homer, this is Seeker.
Seeker, this is Homer.
Seeker, this is Homer. Come in, Seeker. Seeker, do you copy? Seeker, this is Homer.
Homer, this is Franklin. What do you want me to do, sir?
You have your orders, Lieutenant. Stay where you are.
I saw you. I saw what you did.
What'd you see me do, Eve? Huh? What'd I do?
I saw you. I saw what you did. I saw what happened.
What did I do, Eve? What did you see me do?
I saw you.
Eve, don't.
Don't do it. He didn't kill her. It wasn't him.
Are we going in, sir?
No, stay right here, soldier. Right here.
He didn't do it, Eve.
He didn't kill her. It wasn't him.
I saw you. I saw what happened.
Eve, can you hear me?
Eve, listen to me. He didn't kill her. It wasn't him. Eve, do you hear me?
Eve, it's okay. He's your friend, Eve. Don't harm him. Eve, please don't harm him.
This is Homer. Come in, Seeker. Come in, Seeker.
Yeah, okay.
Outside.
Yes, sir, I'm okay. But we've got three dead Marines and a dead civilian here. And Target is still at large. Repeat, Target is still at large. Seeker out.
Boy, fucked up, General. We had her. We fucking had her.
Eagle, this is Seeker. I need you to make a sweep north of the Simmons place.
Copy that, Seeker.
What did you mean when you said I didn't kill her? Kill who?
Truth is, I've kept it hidden away for so long that now I've begun to wonder if it ever really happened.
Look! Please! Don't touch me!
I was 5, almost 6 years old. was raining hard that day. We'd gone to pick up my father. He'd been drinking at a local bar. He liked to drink sometimes.
I'm not gonna calm down!
Well, that day he was very drunk, too drunk to drive. And he got very angry when my mother wouldn't let him have the car keys. Out of the car, arguing by the side of a busy road.
Come over here! Give me the keys!
I'm not gonna get in the car and I'm gonna drive you home!
I'm not gonna get nothing in the
Bill,
car!
Get in the car!
I am sick! Give me the keys, you bitch!
Don't call me a bitch!
I'll call you whatever I want, you bitch! Now give me the goddamn keys!
You're just drunk!
I'm not drunk, I'm happy!
Bill,
don't give me any of your shit about
Bill,
it! Give me the goddamn Bill, keys, you bitch! I've had enough of this! You're not gonna take me
Bill.
In! Get out of
you're
my face,
me.
Bitch! Jesus,
Catherine! What happened? I don't know. Well, fell or pushed or slipped, he was guilty. He'd been killing her for years and now he'd done it forever. Hardly spoke after she died. Well, time didn't improve things. I got more angry about what had happened.
Where do you think she'll go now?
New York.
Why New York?
To see Timmy, my son.
You sure about New York?
I know what she's doing now. It sounds crazy, but she's going back through my life. Only there are no barriers, no stop signs. Whatever damage she sustained destroyed all her inhibitions. She's doing things I might think about doing, but would never dare to do. Or have the courage to do.
We gotta be right about New York. Otherwise, we're gonna be in the wrong place at the wrong time, and a lot of innocent people are gonna die.
Quade, what really matters to me is to be a good mother to Timmy. And I know that's what she's feeling right now. She'll go to New York to get my son.
I gotta be sure that
we're... But Quade, I know I'm right.
We've dispatched hit teams to LaGuardia, JFK, and Newark.
Do we know what flight she's on?
We're checking, sir. There's lots of permutations.
I'm afraid, gentlemen, it's true confessions time. The president will have to be told, and New York mayor's office have to be alerted so we can put evacuation plans in operation.
Look, you've got to give us more time. If we choke up the streets with thousands of panicked residents, we'll never get to her.
The general's right, sir. It's do or die now.
Jesus. Then do it.
Seeker, EVE-8 may have a few hours head start on us, but we will have surveillance in place in New York.
This must all be routine for you.
What's routine?
Dead bodies, people getting killed.
I've seen a lot of my friends put in plastic bags and shipped home. It's not routine. Look, we believe in something. We do what we do because we think it'll help people, maybe stop a war. We don't set out to destroy. We set out to preserve a way of life that we think is important. Point is, your intentions were good. Even if you did forget to put in the fucking off switch.
Thanks, McQuay.
Eve, I hope you know I'm going to do everything possible not to harm your son. But this thing may come down to some hard choices.
I know.
What's he doing?
I think he's learning Russian. Some damn thing.
Shouldn't we get the husband and kid out of there?
If we move them, she may not show. Unit 1, this is Condor.
This is Unit 1. All clear.
Unit 2.
All quiet around back.
Unit 3.
He's down in the street.
Very nice.
Condor, this is Unit 3. All clear.
Condor, this is Seeker. We're about 15 minutes away from you.
We copy that, Seeker.
Unit 3, where's that woman's dog? She hasn't got her dog with her. Unit 3, come in. Come in, Unit 3. Unit 3, come in. Unit 1, we've got trouble.
Condor, this is Unit 1. Unit 3's dead. The target is in the building, I repeat. The target is in the building.
Eve? What are you doing here? I missed something here?
Jimmy's here, isn't he?
Well, sure, it's the weekend. Whew, now, that's a different look. Is everything, what's the matter? What's wrong?
Where's Timmy?
Are you okay?
I need to see my son. Where is he? I need to see him now.
Hold on here. What the hell is going on here?
Hi, Mom.
Hey, what Timmy.
What are you doing here?
You miss me, don't you? You do miss me, don't you? Timmy, I love you. You know that.
I'm sorry we don't spend more time together, Timmy.
Eve? Look, you're upset, okay? Maybe we should just sit down and talk about it, okay?
Please.
Eve! Let's talk, okay?
Please?
Come on. We'll sit down. We'll get some coffee, all right? Hey, Timmy, you want to help me make your mom some coffee? Okay, come on.
Okay?
Yeah, she's gonna be fine. Hello?
Peter?
Yes?
This is gonna be difficult. It's Eve.
What?
The woman in your apartment is not me.
Who the hell is this?
Look through the window.
What?
Listen carefully. Your life and Timmy's depend on how you act in the next few minutes.
You know what I've been working on. Peter.
Yeah.
She's one of my robots, Peter.
And she's very dangerous.
Oh, shit.
What's wrong?
What am I supposed to do? What am I supposed to do?
Tell him to get Timmy out of there. Come down in the elevator and we'll meet him in the lobby.
Hey, are you still there?
Peter?
Yes.
You've got to get Timmy out of the apartment. Somebody will meet you in the lobby. Do you hear me?
Yeah, I hear you.
Well, then do it now, please.
ambulance.
She's used the emergency exit.
Get my back.
Copy that, Seeker. Project the area of damage. Dear God.
Seeker, dead and injured on 53rd and 5th Station. Target believed headed for Lexington Avenue. I'm in pursuit. Stay down!
Wait! Okay, evacuate Lexington Avenue and stop the trains. And you better tell the New York Police Department to stay the hell out of this. I don't want anybody taking a pot shot at it.
Sir, the transit authorities say their computers are going haywire. They can't stop the trains.
It's her.
Hey,
the hell are you looking at?
Mommy will protect you, I promise.
Doc, want to give me a hand here? Fucking off switch, I think. We'll be right back.
In just a few minutes' time at 12...